Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the second China-UAE conference on Islamic banking and finance, organized by the Dubai Islamic Economic Development Center, Dubai Center for Islamic Banking and Finance at Hamdan Smart University, Shenzhen Financial Chamber of Commerce, China Islamic Finance Club, the Chin International Culture, Thomson Reuters as a knowledge partner. Under the partners in alignment with the initiative of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Vice President and the Prime Minister of the UAE and ruler of Dubai, to establish Dubai as the capital of the Islamic economy, and the President of China initiative One Belt, One Road. This initiative, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, has become central to China's evolving role in global economy. It will boost the flow of trade, capital, services between China and more than 65 countries along that route, representing 63% of the world population and 29% of the world GDP. While requiring a huge investment in networks, highways, railways, and seaports, it will no doubt result in enormous opportunities throughout Asia, Africa, and Europe. Infrastructure projects in Asia alone are estimated to cost $22.6 trillion by 2030. That is $1.5 trillion a year. There is no single source, ladies and gentlemen, that can supply this type of funding. The Asia Infrastructure Investment Bank, the Silk Road Fund, and the New Development Bank have committed approximately $1.1 trillion. Needed funds are therefore required for infrastructure projects, which exceeds what's available from these institutions, making it necessary for alternative mode of financing and additional funds to be raised from around the world. President Xi has called for the creation of new models of investment and encourage greater cooperation between government and the private capital, with Islamic banking and finance playing a growing role in today's global business environment. Its services are now being offered in more than 75 countries by more than 1,000 institutions. With the size of Islamic banking and finance, as estimated by IMF in 2014, $1.8 trillion, but recently in 2017, according to the IFR report, $2.29 trillion, jumping from $2.143 trillion in 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, it was only $639 million in 2007. That is basically 10 years ago. Islamic finance has the potential to contribute to China's economic plan in several dimensions. Its emphasis on asset-backed financing and the profit and loss sharing concept that underlie Islamic finance instruments. It could provide support for small and medium-sized enterprises, as well as infrastructure projects. Islamic finance poses less systematic risk than conventional finance because it is based on the principle of risk sharing and it does not allow speculation. However, for this to take place in China, a number of challenges have to be addressed. First of all, Islamic finance, ladies and gentlemen, is not only for Muslims. That's what we're trying in this conference to put forward. It should be basically put forward for the non-Muslim to gain a larger foothold in China in particular. The growth potential for Islamic finance in China is a huge, given the 1.3 billion population and for the recently approved 300 infrastructure project within the One Belt, One Road strategy, initiative, valued at $1.1 trillion. Even if Islamic finance is only focusing on the Muslim population, which we'd like to discourage, but for that, we are talking about 2% of the population, that's 23 million, representing a huge potential. Islamic finance should be, however, put on equal footing with conventional finance in China. Local laws and regulations, taxes in particular, need to be modified to permit Sharia-compliant investment. This needs the cooperation between the central and local governments to make this happen. There is a lot to be done in China and a lot to be learned about Islamic finance. For this to be successful and create an impact on the Chinese finance and investment decision, this conference is a step in this direction. Since its inception, the Dubai Center for Islamic Banking and Finance at HBMSU has carved a leading role for itself in creating and disseminating knowledge that would go a long way in contributing to the Dubai, the capital of Islamic economy initiative, and in creating a positive impact on Islamic economic development in the UAE. It has strived to try influencing government and social stance on Islamic banking and finance, and has taken a lead for generating useful ideas and projects that could be integrated fruitfully into policies and strategies across the various aspects of the industry. The second China Islamic Finance, Islamic Banking and Finance, the second China UAE Islamic Banking and Finance Conference is a platform to facilitate the dialogue and discussion between policymakers, academic researchers, and practitioners to address the Islamic banking and finance perspectives, challenges, and its ability to create a sustainable impact and contribute to the One Belt, One Road initiative. The main theme for the conference this year is Islamic finance paving the way for the Belt and Road initiative. This two-day conference will feature a comprehensive program, ladies and gentlemen, where distinguished speakers from the financial industry, from the international organizations, from the government, and the private institutions. The keynote addresses will reflect important aspects currently influencing the opportunities for Islamic finance in China, and looks at what will continue to shape that industry for years to come. During the conference, there will be three panel discussions. The purpose of these is to provide an opportunity for the wider participation and to exchange views with carefully selected panel members. The first of these looks at the need for strategic partnership between UAE and China that goes beyond oil, which His Excellency alluded to earlier on, and the prospects for that to take place. The second looks at the possibility to eliminate trade barriers within the country along the One Road, One Belt strategy, and that is to expand the trade links with the Middle East and Southeast Asia as well. The third panel discussion examines how can Chinese government enhance its cooperation with the Muslim countries through Islamic finance. The finding of two reports will be presented during the conference. The first examines key findings from the Islamic Finance and Development Indicator Report, the implication for the One Belt and Road Strategy by Thomson and Reuters. The second provides the key finding from Islamic Wealth Management Report 2017 from EDIS Corporation in the UK. The conference will also feature many formal and informal networking opportunities, including an exclusive gala dinner, bringing together practitioners, industry leaders, and supporters of Islamic finance. This conference reflects the commitment of HBMSU Chancellor Dr. Mansour Al-Awad to facilitate strategic partnership and alliances with Dubai Plan, Dubai Government Initiative, and the wider UAE strategy. I am grateful for the support of Dr. Mansour, whose confidence and determination to lead the university into leading contributor to His Highness initiative is highly commendable. I'm grateful for the support of His Excellency, Mr. Abdullah Al-Awad, the CEO of Dubai Islamic Economic Development Center, for his support throughout the preparation for the conference. I would like to thank you, Your Excellency, keynote speakers, panel discussion members, moderators, and presenters, for sharing your expert views and contribute to the conference. I'm also grateful for the conference advisory committee for taking the time to contribute to the conference. This conference would not have been possible without the effort and dedication of several people and teams in both China and the UAE. Ms. Hong Li, the CEO of China Islamic Finance Club, is the key for this. Ms. Ali Wong and their team in China, Mr. Saeed Kharbash and his team in Dubai, Mr. Ammar and his team in Bahrain with Thomson Reuters, and my colleagues at HBMSU, all of those people worked very hard to prepare for the conference and put together an impressive program. I hope we can open the door for opportunities to integrate available resources and best practices so as to promote effective and innovative partnership between participants and institutions presented here today. A sincere welcome to you all, and we wish you an enjoyable and fruitful sharing experience at the second China-UAE Conference on Islamic Banking and Finance. Thank you.